Hello, everybody. I'm gonna be teaching you guys how to make a gorilla tag thumbnail. First of all, you want to go to Photopea. I'll have it on the description. New project. Then you want to change it to 128 by 720. Then you want to hit create. And what you want to do, you want to find a background image. I already have one, which is here. And then after that, you want to hit shift. And then, drag it. If you don't hit shift, then it'll look weird to hit shift and then drag it to fit here. And then what you want to do is that you want to go to, you can go to image, transform, no, you could go to image adjustments, brightness and contrast, you'd like turn it up and down. You kind of want to make it pop a bit more, so I might have it like that. Then after that, go to filter, blur, motion blur, and change it between 2 and 10 pixels. Or else it could be too strong, it could, hurt. I'll have it at 4, so that's good. Then what you want to do is that you can delete the background like I'm going to rename this to background. It's just easier. Then you want to open up Blender. Sorry about this, I don't have it open. Then you want to hit open. Gorilla tag IK rig, I'll have in this description. All you need to do is that you want to click the link. Again, let me show you. So you want to click the link, right? Okay. Want to click the link, then go to Gorilla tag Nacho rig and release it. So then you just want to click there. And then download it. And then what you want to do after you open up to here, you want to hit this, and you'll see the color and the materials. Go to primary color, change it to what you want. I'm gonna make it purple for this video. Change the brightness. If you're gonna do black, don't do black black. Do a little bit of a brighter black so it looks like it has some material. Because black black is not the right gorilla type black. I'm gonna do purple. And I got pencil color, which is kind of like the background. I haven't seen it working. So put that whatever you want. It'll have a glow on the sides. And then what you want to do is that after you got all this, you want to click on lines. You want to go to file, not file. You want to click on the lines, go to pose mode, and now you're able to change the pose. The gorilla, if you need to. Just move the hand up and down. Don't do what you want. Do it again. Okay, and if you want, there's a way to mirror it. Don't quite know how to, which, is fine. But, we don't need to. This, you can just close. Me too. I don't want to. I forget how to close it. I'll remember. There you go. Yep. Close it. Now, what you want to do? Just click on the line, see what you want. And move this hand up. Just move this hand. Move it up like that. Let's move them forwards a bit. Move this one up. I'm not gonna do that anymore. Make it look nice. Like, just play around with it, try to find something that you want. There's nothing that you can't do. It's like whatever you want. And if you wanna rotate it, just change it to R, you can rotate it like that. You want. There should be a way to just rotate it. Could be a rotate tool. So. Yeah, rotate twice, you can change it like that. Give me a moment. This, oh wait, you need, yep, you have to go to layout. I'm dumb. You have to hit layout. And then now you can rotate it. Sorry about that. You can rotate the hands to how you want. Change it to like there. I think that looks good. Right? Does it look good? Let's see. I don't know how that somehow just worked out. All right, maybe you want it like that. I'll just keep it like this for now. Then what you want to do is that you want to rotate. Then you want to go to object mode, and there you go. It's stay like this. Want to go to add. Also, you can just shrink this. I recommend having it like that. There. I'll move this down too. The only one to do is that you want to go to add camera. Let's go behind here. Then if you go to view, yeah, nope. View, give me a moment. It's been a little bit since I've done this. Well, okay, you go to either, yeah, if you go to navigation, you walk navigation. Now, you have to line it up the monkey as perfectly as you can. And you want to just flip. And then that's how you want it. You want to move the camera. Also, you can move these if you need to. I'm going to actually go back to pose mode to move those, these back here. If you move the shoulders, I might move them up. That. Yeah, I think that looks a little bit better. Now, if you go back to object mode. And then the thing about the camera is that it's gonna be a little bit in the ground to pull it up. Not that much, but. Let's see about there. And then you want to look from here. You want to look from where the monkey is. Does it line up both? And then, I think you got it. You want to go to render, render image, and then room mode to load. This is how it looks like right now. That's pretty good. And if you got it how you like it, go to image. Then save as. Then wait, I'm just going to keep it as untitled. You want to go back here. File, open in place. Then you want to select the image. But as you can see, there's background. So, you want to go to remove.bg, I'll put in the description, and put in the title. And then it removes the background. And go back to photo feed, open place, and that'll remove. And then you want to like hide, if there's a gorilla there, you kind of want to hide it. So, get that place. Right. And then if you can do this by doing here, if you want to add a stroke to them, like I'm gonna do, not like that. That's not how you do it. Just turn off the stroke if you do that. If you double click here, then you can change the size if you want it like thicker. Like I'm gonna have it there, change the color, and then you could add a drop shadow there. I'm not gonna do it though. Add outer below, same thing. You. I might change it to red. I think I want the thing, like, the size of it. I'm gonna have it like there. Just kind of makes it pop a bit. And then what you want to do for that, you probably want words, right? Just make a text box. I'm gonna say, thumbnail, right? can like scale it up to how you want it. Also, I recommend you make the box like fit to size, so it's gonna be big for me. I might have it like that. So then you sort of want the box fit to here so it looks better. And then what you want to do, that you want to go to warp. This is just if you want, you do like shell upper. I'm actually gonna do shell lower. I like it more. Then I'm gonna do 11 here. Look how it looks here. You like it? Then if you want to move it, just go back to here. You can put it in front or behind. I usually put it behind, so you just drag this down to there. Put it above him. Then, if you want to add some effects, I recommend you do. Okay, first I'm gonna change the color of it because I don't want black. I don't like it. I might do white. Yeah, I'm probably just gonna do white. And now let's go here. Rope. Our glow. And I'm probably gonna have it same thing as the gorilla. I'm gonna move it down. Can't move it where we want. Actually move it in front of the gorilla. That. I'm actually gonna change it a bit to the effect. Have a gradient overlay to make that look better. I've done that before. Blur overlay, same thing. But you can add an inner glow, and that will just, make it pop a bit more. So make it look red. You can make it look a bit more, glow a bit more, bigger. I do recommend putting a drop shadow on your images. This, and you can change the direction of the shadow. I like to just keep it at either like there. Spread. That's like how big it is. I think I'll keep it like this. And what you want to do from here is that if you think you're done and you like it, just file, export as a PNG. And just save it. Oh, whatever you want, I'm gonna call it new project. And yeah, that's how you make it.